Hi, welcome back to our next training session. I am Hitendra Kumar Shah, Pharmaceutical Compliance Consultant, CGMP Trainer and Auditor from NADH Plus GXP Compliance Services. Hope you evaluated stability testing program as a common problem in recent FDA warning letters. A recent published evaluation has shown that non-conformance regarding inadequate stability testing is found in about every fifth warning letter in the year 2016, 18 and 2019. This trend seems to continue for 2020 also, because the three of the warning letter posted in January 2020 also deal with the same problem. The major observation related to stability studies are: the firm failed to establish and follow an adequate written testing procedure designed to assess the stability characteristics of a drug product and to use results of such a stability testing to determine appropriate storage conditions and expiration dates. The firm failed to conduct a long-term stability study to support expiration date of the over-the-counter or OTC drug product. The another observation is the firm did not have an adequate stability testing program to demonstrate that the chemical properties of OTC drug product remain acceptable throughout their labeled expiry period. For example, the firm's stability testing program does not include an assay determination of the active ingredient in the OTC drug products. The firm lacked adequate stability data to support the labeled 2-year expiration date. Specifically, the firm failed to test for assay at the time of intervals specified in their accelerated stability testing program used to support the expiration date. Also, the firm could not follow long-term stability study. Therefore, the firm do not have adequate data to support stability of the drug product throughout its labeled shelf life. Due to all these observations, to increase the awareness about the importance of the stability studies, I am here to discuss with you about stability studies as per ICH guideline. Stability testing of drug products is mandatory by 21 CFR part 211.166 of the CGMP guidelines and also all other CGMP guidelines. It is a fundamental GMP requirement. A stability testing program should demonstrate that the quality parameters of the drug substance and drug products remain acceptable throughout their labeled shelf life period. Inadequate stability studies that do not provide the shelf life of the drug product may cause facility to fail an FDA inspection and receive a warning letter. Today, we will discuss about some basic requirements of the guideline, which will include specifically selection of the batches, container closure system, specification, storage condition, testing frequency, stability commitment, etc. It is mandatory that data from stability studies should be provided on at least 3 primary batches of the drug product. So, 3 batches should be selected for stability study. These batches should be of the same formulation and packaged in the same container closure system as proposed for marketing. Where possible, batches of the drug product should be manufactured by using different batches of the drug substance. Stability testing should be conducted on the dosage form packaged in the container closure system proposed for the marketing. In many drug substance manufacturing firms, the primary packaging material is polythene bags. During stability study, the polythene bags are not evaluated for similarity in GSM in line with the bags used for commercial purpose. Stability studies should include testing of those tests of the drug product that are susceptible to change during storage and are likely to influence quality, safety and or efficacy. Such tests are called stability indicating tests. The testing should cover as appropriate the physical, chemical, biological, microbiological attributes, preservative content, for example, antioxidant, antimicrobial preservatives, and also functionality test, for example, in case of inhalers, a dose delivery system also need to be evaluated. A drug substance or the drug product should be evaluated under storage conditions that test its thermal stability, and if applicable, its sensitivity to moisture or potential for solvent loss. The storage conditions and the length of the study chosen should be sufficient to cover storage, shipment, and subsequent use. Stability testing of the drug product after reconstitution or dilution, if applicable, should be conducted to provide information for the labeling or the preparation, storage conditions, and in use period of the reconstituted or diluted product. For storage conditions, different climatic zones are recommended. For example, zone 1, zone 2, zone 3, zone 4A, zone 4B, etc. However, it is suggested to refer the specified temperature and humidity conditions for the long-term studies as per the WHO guide recommendation. Photostability testing, if required, it should be conducted on at least one primary batch of the drug product, if justified. The standard conditions for the photostability testing are described in the ICH Q1B guide. If protect from light is stated in one of the officially recognized pharmacopoeias for the API or finished pharmaceutical product, it is sufficient to state protect from light on labeling in lieu of photostability studies when the container closure system is shown to be light protective. Additional stress testing of specific types of dosage forms may be appropriate. For example, cyclic studies for semi-solid products or freeze-thaw studies for liquid products, etc. All the accelerated storage conditions, a minimum of 3 time points, for example 0 or initial, 3 months and 6 months are considered for the study. While for long-term studies, the frequency of testing at the long-term storage condition should normally be every 3 months over the first year, after that every 6 months over the second year, and after that annually thereafter up to the proposed shelf life. For example, if the product is with 48 months shelf life, it should be tested for long term study with the frequency of 0 or initial, then 3, 6, 9, 12, 18, 24 months and 36 months, and finally up to 48 months shelf life. When available long-term stability data on primary batches do not cover the proposed retest period granted at a time of approval, a commitment or commitment letter should be made to the regulatory agency to continue the stability studies post-approval in order to firmly establish the retest period. Hope with this you got fair idea about importance of stability study, common citations related to the stability studies, and basics about how to conduct the stability study. In addition to the stability studies and the other trainings, you can take the benefit of our audit and compliance services, which include all these services. If you are on the way for facing the regulatory audit or preparing the compliance report to the observations, or need any specific training, you can contact us through the numbers or the emails displayed on the screen. Due to some time or financial constraints, if you cannot attend our in-house training or workshop, you can learn multiple cGMP topics from our all videos. My basic purpose of preparing these videos to provide free learning platform. Hence, I request you to share this videos to your colleagues so that they can also get benefit with this video. Further, you can subscribe our YouTube channel so that you will get notification about the new videos. The subscribing YouTube channel is absolutely free of cost. If you are interested in other topic, please feel free to contact us. Thank you so much, and ensure all time compliance.